This is an update to the video that I made in February of this year. A month and a day ago, I had an appointment with my neurologist at Vanderbilt, and I had arranged to go in the hospital after that for plasma exchange. It was late in the afternoon when they were able to get me in the hospital. While I was waiting in the admitting office, the neurology team came and saw me. They took me back to a private room where nobody was in the admitting office, and they examined me, and after the examination, they went ahead and decided to admit me to the neuro ICU step-down unit because my situation was much worse than it was in the previous video I did in early February of 2016, previous video. My single breath count was down to around 16. They talked about intubating me, but nobody really wanted me intubated, including myself. So they could monitor me closely in that ICU step down. So that's where I was. 1 month ago today, which was the next day, they were able to insert the vascular catheter. That was my 13th. And later that afternoon, they started the plasma exchange. It was a 1.5 or 150% exchange. The next morning at 8 a.m., they started the second exchange. So within 18 hours, I had 300% of my blood exchanged. And that is quite a large amount. And it will wreak havoc on your body. Before the exchange, my heart rate resting, sitting here, is in the 60s, laying down. At night, it will drop into the low 50s. They finally set the alarm down to 45 because I kept tripping it at 50. Even at 45, I would set it off occasionally. Nothing unusual for me. I have bradycardia. My blood pressure would run somewhere around 130 over 80. At night, it would drop sometimes to 100 over 60. Nothing unusual with medication. That's about normal for me. Once plasmapheresis or PLEX started, my blood pressure would go all over the place. It would be high 1 minute and be low the next. The highest reading, and they think was probably an abnormality, was like 200 over 110. And they said, that can't be right. So they took it again. It was like 185 over 95. So they don't think that first reading was quite right. And at night, one time it dropped down to like 80 over 40. So blood pressure was up and down. Anytime I have PLEX, my heart rate almost doubles. It went from my average of around 60, 65 to running an average of anywhere from 100 to 120. When I stood, it would easily go to 130. So that's why I like to do plasma exchange in the hospital. I was there a total of 7 days from the time of admission to the time I came home. They do not do plasma exchange on Sunday. And immediately after the last plasma exchange, we started the process of chemotherapy. I'm on 4 rounds of Cytoxan. The first one was in the hospital, and I'll have 3 more. The next one is this coming Wednesday. So one of the purposes of these videos is to show you what has happened. It's been a month since I went in the hospital, a month today that I had my first exchange. So let's see what has happened. Let me do a breath count test just to see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36. Not bad. I'm happy with that. One of the things I did was click like I do clicking for the dogs. Much faster, much better. Pretty even on both sides. Snapping my fingers. Better and faster. A little better than I could last time. The penny box. I have it right here. Again, the same box of pennies, 17 pounds that I've been using. Let's see what I can do. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 24, and it stops. I did, I think, 3 last time. The left hand, if I remember correctly, I could not do any. 1, 2, 3, 4, and I can keep going, but I'm not going to win myself. If you would notice, I'm winded, but not nearly as bad as I was last time, which is a great big improvement. Huge improvement, though. Last time I would have winded much quicker. And that is a big workout for me right there. Okay, I feel stronger. Let's see if I can stand from a seated position. I have no idea if I can or can't. Haven't tried. Nope, can't do that without cheating, leaning forward like this. So I still cannot stand from a seated position. Okay. I will try walking on my heels. Again, I'm balanced on the treadmill behind me. And I'm very careful. I have this to grab to. I'm up on my heels and making sure I feel secure before I even try this. No problem. And if you saw the previous video, I could not take one step. So right now, I'm probably at the peak of my strength. And you can see that the plasma exchange and chemo does help me. It took me about, I'd say, 3 months to recover from the combined effects. It knocks me for a loop when I have that feel just exhausted. The nausea medicine helps the nausea, but it still upsets your stomach and just makes you extremely tired and weak feeling. Once I start going downhill and it's noticeable, I'll do another video. Again, you can tell my breathing is still affected. That is the part that never gets 100% for me, but the core body strength is there. And I'm thrilled anytime that is back and I can move again. The breathing, I've pushed myself, but you have to learn to pace yourself. And for this video, I did not. But that was the purpose of this video, to show you what I could do for documentation purposes. So until next time, everybody be safe, and I'll see you then. Goodbye.